Let's take a look at a word problem that involves derivatives. So actually the type of word problem we're going to do in this video is a really popular and common type of word problem for derivatives, and it's about a population growth model. So here's a scenario. Gnats are taking over your kitchen. You want to find out, is there any hope at all? Are they just going to keep growing forever, or is there some hope of reclaiming your house? So let's find out. The population of gnats in our story is given by the following function, where t is measured in days. So p of t equals 1,000 over 1 plus 5e to the negative 0.3t. And once again, t here just represents time measured in days. So for example, if I plugged in 5 to this function, that would give me the population of gnats on day 5. So part A asks us to calculate the instantaneous growth rate of the population for any time point greater than or equal to zero. So the phrase instantaneous growth rate, an instantaneous rate of change, should spark in your mind that what we're looking for here is the derivative. Okay, and we're looking for the derivative just for any time in general. So I just want to find the derivative of the function p of t. So that's p prime of t that I'm looking for here. Now in this case, I'm going to have to use the quotient rule to find that derivative. So remember the quotient rule says, or the formula for the quotient rule is bottom times the derivative of the top minus top times the derivative of the bottom over the bottom squared. Okay, so in this case, that's bottom 1 plus 5e to the negative 0.3t times the derivative of the top, the derivative of 1,000, minus the top, 1,000, times the derivative of the bottom, 1 plus 5e to the negative 0.3t, all over the bottom squared. And let me fix here a little typo I made in the top. This should be d dt, so I'm taking the derivative with respect to time here. So d dt for all my derivatives. Okay, so let's continue working out this derivative by working through some of those derivatives on the top. So 1 plus 5e to the negative 0.3t times the derivative with respect to time of 1,000. So 1,000 is just a constant, so its derivative is 0. Minus 1,000 times the derivative of 1 plus 5e to the negative 0.3t. Okay, let me remind you out to the side here of an important derivative. The derivative of e to the kx equals ke to the kx. Okay, so applying that to our situation, we're taking the derivative with respect to time, but it's the same form. So the derivative of the 1 is just going to be 0. And then I'm going to keep the 5 out front. And then the derivative of e to the negative 0.3t is going to be negative 0.3e to the negative 0.3t. Okay, so that was a lot of pieces, but hopefully you were able to catch all of that. Okay, so we finished taking our derivatives. Let me just clean this up here a little for us. Okay, and I still have 1 plus 5e to the negative 0.3t squared on the bottom. So let's clean up that numerator just a little bit, and then we'll be done with this step. So p prime of t. So this first term on the top is just going to be 0. It's 0 times this 1 plus 5e to the negative 0.3t, but that's just 0. So then I'm going to have minus my other piece. So let's try to combine some of these pieces here. So I've got three constants, essentially, that I'm multiplying together. I've got 1,000, 5, and 0.3. So 5 times 0.3 is 1.5, and then 1,000 times 1.5 is 1,500. Now be careful about the sign. I've got two negatives involved here. So a negative, this one, times a negative equals a positive. So this is going to be positive 1500. And then I still got my e to the negative 0.3t. And then the bottom, just can stay as it is. Okay, so this is our derivative. This gives us the instantaneous rate of change of the gnat population at any point in time that we should plug in. So that's the end of part one. Okay, so let's see, what does part two ask for part B? When approximately is the instantaneous growth rate of the population the greatest? Okay, you know what, actually, let's do part C first, because I'm going to show you a graph to answer part B, but I don't want to give away the answer to part C. So let's go ahead and do part C, and then we'll come back to B. So part C asks, what is the limit as t goes to infinity of p prime of t? And then how would you describe in words the meaning of this limit? So let's do the second part first, actually. Let's think about what this is asking us to find conceptually. So the limit as t goes to infinity of p prime of t. So p prime of t is what we just found, and we said that was the rate of change of the gnat population at any point in time. So what I'm asking for here is at very large times, so it's at times far in the future, what is the rate of change of the gnat population is essentially what this is asking. So we could say something like at times very far in the future, how is the population changing? And this is a useful question, because we might want to know, is the population changing rapidly in the future? Is it, you know, is it still increasing rapidly? Is it decreasing perhaps? Is it not changing? So let's find out by actually taking this limit. So we want the limit as time goes to infinity of what we just found, the derivative, which was 1500 e to the negative 0.3 t over 1 plus 5 e to the negative 0.3 t squared. So this is maybe a sort of daunting function to take the limit of. But it's really not if you break it up. Remember that limit laws allow us to break limits up. We can look at the different pieces separately. So really, the most scary piece here is this e to the negative 0.3t. So let's just out to the side, take the limit of that piece, see what it is, and then we will stick it back in. So out here to the side, I just want to think about the limit as time goes to infinity of just e to the negative 0.3t. Now, a way I can rewrite this that's very helpful, this is a negative exponent, so I can actually move it to the denominator like this. And this perhaps, for a lot of people, makes it a little easier to think about the limit. So think about plugging in larger and larger values of t. What's happening to this quantity overall? Well, as I plug in larger and larger values of time, the denominator of this fraction is getting larger and larger and larger. And we know from previous examples and lessons that that means this fraction overall is actually approaching zero. Okay, so now I know that this piece here is going to zero. And similarly, this piece here is going to zero. Okay, so what do I get? I've got on the top 1500 times zero, so that's just zero. And then on the bottom, I've got 1 plus zero. So I see that this limit equals zero. So what does that tell me? That tells me that I should expect, when we look at the graph of this function, that as time goes to infinity, the function is approaching zero, which tells me that the rate of change of the population approaches zero at times far in the future. So let's actually go ahead and look at the graph. And I actually have it pulled up on a web page here. And it's a little small. Unfortunately, I cannot zoom in to it without paying money. But this is the graph of the derivative, the graph of p prime of t. And we see that it actually does agree with what we just found, right? So this graph is showing us the rate of change of the population. I see at first the rate of change is increasing. Okay, so the population is growing at a faster and faster rate. So this is giving the rate of change of the population at any point in time. And then that rate of change peaks. Okay, so here's the answer to part B, right? So part B was asking us when approximately the population was changing at the fastest rate. I forget the exact wording. Let's see. When approximately is the instantaneous growth rate the greatest? Okay, so we see that approximately 5, somewhere around 5, a little over 5, would be the answer to part B. And then the rate of change starts to decrease. And then what kind of like what we expected, out here it seems to level out. So we could even go out to like 50. And let's see what would happen in that case. Right, we see that it does level out. So as time goes to infinity, the rate of change of the population approaches zero. That means that the time is far in the future, the population has kind of reached some sort of steady state and it's not really changing anymore. Okay, so we said B about T equals 5. So there's one more thing I'd like to look at with you here, and that's part D. What is the limit as time goes to infinity of the function itself? Okay, so we were looking at the derivative a second ago, but what about the function itself? And then how would you describe in words the meaning of this limit? So let's answer that question once more. Or sorry, first, once again. So the limit as time goes to infinity of the population growth function is going to give us what's often called the steady state of the population. Usually populations just don't grow forever and ever because there's just limiting factors in the environment of whatever organism you're looking at that aren't going to allow it to grow indefinitely. So oftentimes the population model will have the population approach some steady state as time goes to infinity. So the population grows, but then it eventually reaches a certain level and it just stays at that level. So let's take this limit and see what we get. So this is just the limit of the original function, which was 1,000 over 1 plus 5e to the negative 0.3t. Now this is really nice because remember we already found what the limit of this e part is. We found that to be 0. So that makes this really easy. So I've got 1,000 in the top, 1 plus 0 in the bottom, so that's 1,000 over 1, or 1,000. So what this is telling me is that at times far in the future, I expect the gnat population to basically get to 1,000 or very close to 1,000, and then just stay there. And let me show you a graph very quickly to confirm this with you. So here's a graph of the original population function, and we see the population is increasing, and then it levels out. And if I were to go to time equals 100, I would see that the population is still hovering around 1,000 there, approaching 1,000. Okay, so what that tells us about your kitchen is if you do not intervene, that eventually you'll have 1,000 gnats, and you'll have 1,000 gnats. All right, so hopefully this gives you a better understanding of how to approach word problems using derivatives.